In order to set up the shop floor module to work in a machine mode style, we need to first ensure that the machine has been set up. If we go to Infor LN Setup Shop Floor Settings, we should see resources. Each resource relates to a separate machine in LN terms. These should have been downloaded from LN, but if not, they can be set up manually. We need to ensure that the machine is assigned a working time schedule so that when operating in machine mode, we can calculate correctly the amount of time spent between the start and stop. If we're using machine integration, we can define that here and link it to the actual server where the machine integration software is running. I'm not going to go into detail on this yet, as that is out of scope for this particular video. Next, we need to set up a machine user. So I have set up a user called MT1001. And I've assigned to it the group permissions FT base and FT console. These are essential for the machine to be allowed to access the appropriate screens. As far as licensing is concerned, we have assigned factory track base and factory track shop floor ELN, which are required if running on-premise, or factory track cloud if running in the cloud. If we look at the factory track information, we see that the user type associated with it is a machine. Whether or not the machine operator can change the clock is determined by this flag. We need to ensure that the menu group ID associated with this user is LN machine. And here we need to link it to the actual machine in the shop floor module. So I'm saying the username I'm using is MT1001, and that is connected to the resource ID or machine MT1001. The system is now configured so that MT1001, if they log into the shop floor module, they will automatically be logged in machine mode.